through RTE. Southern Oregon University is honoring students who earned 8 credits or more. Earn the skill in either English or literature. Our Chamber Orchestra plays third in state, their highest rating in over 20 years. Band, once again, champions of the Northwest. In the career, field seniors Sheard and Huber Cantula were state champions in field welding. Advantage of credit. In the state in golf, Boyd finished third in the state. And Boyd finished in the top 10 in the state in track. Our wrestling team finished fifth in the state. Our cheerleaders finished third in the state. And Parker Jarvis was a state champion in track. Sitting in front of us are members of our fourth class of AVID graduates, among them many who will be the first in their families to attend college. Most impressive and inspirational are the students seated on the field who are the first high school graduates in their family. Others of inspiration are those that have overcome many life difficulties, including family tragedies, cancer, homelessness, and other difficulties, and are seated here today and will become graduates of Grants Pass High School. Class of 2023, you are all here because you earned the minimum number of credits required by the state of Oregon. But I am here to tell you, class of 23, that you have gone well beyond what is required of you. You have gone the extra mile, and tonight we pay tribute to each of you. At this time, all band, orchestra, and choir students, please move to the front for the playing of the Battle Hymn of the Republic. Outstanding job. At this time, the class of 2023 remembers two classmates that were special to them, Taylor Rice and Eston Swafford. Please join me in a moment of silence as we remember them. Thank you. At this time, our orchestra students will now play Amazing Grace in their memory. Thank you, Mr. Norfleet. Any graduates that are in the music section, you may return to your seats. The class of 2023 has distinguished itself in many areas. The following seniors have earned the honor of class valedictorian. They have excelled not only academically, but also beyond the classroom. It is a pleasure to introduce Ellie Elise Berg. Ellie is the daughter of Shelby and Jeff Berg. Rebecca Leidy. Rebecca is the daughter of Archie and Holly Leidy. Bella Marshak. Bella is the daughter of Stephen Marshak and Elizabeth Herney. Paige Pastrell. Paige is the daughter of Peter Pastrell and Shay Marsh. Joshua Smith. Joshua is the son of David Smith and Felicia Cohen. I would now like to introduce you to Ellie Berg.
While life never goes exactly as planned, we can live life to the fullest as we look for the good in every situation. There's no doubt that trials and adversity will come our way, but it's through these challenges that we can grow stronger. When we expand our perspective, count our blessings, and practice gratitude, we set ourselves up for success, allowing ourselves to overcome things that we didn't think were possible. One of the main lessons I learned throughout high school was that God's plan is greater. Whether it be in athletics, music, clubs, theater, or academics, each of us has had a unique high school journey. I can't imagine that at the beginning of our freshman year, any of us would have guessed that we could have breakfast in bed during our first period Zoom class. There's probably been both tears and laughter throughout the highs and lows, but I know that he's been by our side every step of the way. The many different ways in which we've excelled, succeeded, persevered, and even failed has brought us together to graduate and celebrate as a class of 2023. God's plan has allowed us to make friendships and memories that will last a lifetime. God's plan has helped us become the people we are today. And while I know we have a long way to go and a lot to learn, the experiences we've had these past 4 years will prepare us to face future challenges. While each of us is going to walk across the stage and receive our diploma, I think even more important than recognizing good grades, awards, or schooling is recognizing the people we've become. I want to thank all of you for making a difference in my high school journey. I'm so grateful for the memories, experiences, and years of school we've had together. I'd also like to thank all of the teachers, coaches, and staff members who have helped me achieve my goals. And lastly, I would like to thank all of the families out there who've supported us from the beginning. Mom and Dad, I couldn't have done without you, and I appreciate your love more than you know. Class of 2023, always remember the things we've learned and overcome these past 4 years. There's limitless potential inside each of us, and I can't wait to see all of the amazing things that we do. Thank you. I would now like to introduce Rebecca Leidy.
Congratulations, class of 2023. We finally made it. I remember being a kindergartner and looking at the seniors during the parade of graduates and thinking how it would be forever until I reached that point. Those seniors were the grown-ups who were just starting their lives. But forever is now here, and it is our turn to be those grown-ups. I think it's intimidating thinking of the future sometimes, but when I start to worry, I always go back to some of the best advice I've ever received. The only thing constant in life is change. Personally, I had so much trouble picking a college and a major and housing. I was so scared of making the wrong decision that I almost didn't decide at all. My parents even gave me a deadline to pick a college because they thought that I wasn't going to be able to choose. But this is where my advice comes in. The only thing constant in life is change. I'm not ashamed to admit that I'm scared for the future. Can you guys still hear me? Oh. Okay. Hello? Okay. And I'm not exactly sure of what I'm doing, but I know that I'm going to be okay because I can always change my path if it's not the right one for me. And so can all of you, as long as we keep choosing to move forward. If we create a life for ourselves that we end up not loving, it does not have to be permanent. We have the power to decide how this next chapter goes, and I know that whatever each of us wants to accomplish, we're going to make it happen. I know this because we are a class full of hard workers, state qualifiers, involved kids, intelligent students, and so much potential. I wanted to say how thankful I am for my senior class, for pushing me to be a better person, for all that we've been through together, and for all the great things that we are going to do. I wanted to also take a second to thank my teachers. I would not have gotten to this point without the knowledge, compassion, and wanting for us to succeed that the teachers at Grants Pass have. Specifically, I would like to thank my leadership teacher, Mr. Matthews, and German teacher, Frau Nash. Finally, I would like to thank my family and friends for loving me and always supporting me. Thank you to my mom, who has always been there to show me support and what a strong, compassionate woman looks like. Thank you to my dad, who's the hardest worker that I know. And thank you to my sisters for teaching me essential skills like sharing and patience, but also for loving me unconditionally. I'm so excited to see where life takes each of us. Thank you. And I would like to now introduce Bella Marshak.
All right, congratulations, guys, we made it. I'd like to start by thanking my friends for all the amazing memories you've made. You guys made high school so much fun. I also want to thank my teachers for always making class interesting and for getting me where I am today, especially Mr. St. Clair, Mr. Swanee, and Mr. Matthews. You all have influenced me in different ways, and I'm so grateful for what you've taught me, not only in class, but like life skills too. So thank you. I want to thank my coaches for making the past 4 years of sports amazing. You guys taught me how to have a strong work ethic, and you made it so much fun. And lastly, thank you to my family for supporting me in everything I do, especially my parents and my brother. Mom, you showed me what being a strong person looks like and have supported me all the time, and I love you so much. And Dad, you make me laugh and have taught me to stand up for what's right. Julian, you're the best brother I could have asked for, and you have to come visit me in college. I'm sure everyone would agree with me when I say that right now our world is kind of chaotic. It seems like everywhere you look, something bad or scary is happening, whether that's a major natural disaster, a war, or another school shooting. It's easy to start to view the world and people with a negative lens, but with all the corruption and badness we see and are surrounded by, but there's also so much good in the world, and we can be a part of that good. Each and every one of us has the decision to make, Each and every one of us can make choices that positively impact others. We can choose to smile at our neighbors as we pass them on the streets. We can choose to thank the cashier at the grocery store. We can choose to pay for the person behind us at Dutch. We can choose to hold the door open for the person whose hands are full. We can always choose kindness. We can always choose kindness, and being kind to others not only benefits them in that moment, but it benefits the world. As Martin Luther King Jr. once said, hate cannot drive out hate, only love can do that. Even when the world is crumbling and it seems like hate is everywhere, kindness will always prevail. It has a ripple effect. So as you embark on this next chapter of your life, I encourage you to look for, as you look for a way to make a difference, I encourage you to reflect on yourself and focus on making selfless, compassionate decisions. Thank you so much for making the past 4 years amazing. Thank you. I'd like to introduce Paige Pastoreau.
Welcome, friends, family, students, and staff. I'm so glad you could all be all here on this joyous occasion to celebrate your class. Looking back over these last 4 years has reminded me of all the memories and fun times we've shared together. Whether that's walking to the park with Mrs. Lorschbow, watching Mr. Kennedy trying to prove himself by doing 40 push-ups, well, he almost did. Realizing how much money I actually spend in Mrs. McNulty's, or pouring my heart and soul into my essays for Mrs. Conley. I wouldn't be here without my parents, so thank you, Mom, for always being a solid rock that I could depend on when life got crazy. Thank you, Dad, for supporting and encouraging me in all my endeavors. My fellow graduates, as we create new paths for ourselves, let us not forget the power of kindness and empathy. Let's strive to make a positive impact on the lives of others. Our successes will not be defined solely by titles or achievements, but by the positive change we bring to the world. So, my friends, as you embark on this new journey of yours. Strive to be the best version of yourselves. Be bold, courageous, and unafraid to pursue your dreams and passions with sheer determination. Thank you. I would now like to introduce to you Josh Smith.
Before I begin, I'd like to thank my parents, grandparents, step-parents, godparents, Fairly Odd Parents, and all other parental figures in my life for helping me reach this stage today. I would also like to thank my two younger brothers, Ben and Noah. Thank you, Ben, for teaching me how to be a patient learner, and thank you, Noah, for showing me the art of wearing shorts all winter and sweatpants all summer. Ladies and gentlemen, faculty, parents, grandmas and grandpas, and my fellow soon-to-be college freshmen, my name is Josh. And for all my classmates, we went to high school together. As one of 10 valedictorians, I'm only given 2 minutes for this speech, so I hope my parents have figured out how to start the video camera by now. It's a big button on the bottom, Mom. Anyways, classmates, I stand before you today as a senior ready to embark on this glorious journey we call college. We've survived the optional SATs, promposals gone wrong, and the dreaded freshman health class with Mr. Y. But here we are, on the precipice of adulthood, with wide eyes and hopes as high as the stacks of textbooks we're about to drag around.
Now, I wanted to give a speech about maintaining meaningful relationships in college. And honestly,
I know what some of you are thinking. Relationships in college? I'm just here for the education, the parties, and the unlimited supply of ramen noodles. But hey, hear me out. College isn't just about acing exams and cramming information into our sleep-deprived brains. It's also about making lifelong connections and unforgettable memories that we'll reminisce about at every reunion. First things first, remember that maintaining relationships in college isn't just about swiping left or right on dating apps. No. It's about cultivating connections that enrich our lives. These next few years are going to be a blur, so hopefully your blur makes you smile. Whether it's a roommate who's got your back when you accidentally set off the fire alarm while attempting to microwave a frozen pizza, or a professor who becomes your mentor and guides you through the maze of your first semester, these relationships matter. Sometimes our friends and mentors can see further into our futures than we can, and imagine a life for us better than even we could have imagined for ourselves. Speaking of roommates, you're going to learn things you never thought you'd learn about people. You'll discover that one of your roommates can do a presentation of a chicken, or that another can balance a stack of books on their head while solving complex math problems, or that a friend like Evan Riggs can do both at once. Cherish these weird moments, my friends, because it's these quirks that make our college experience truly unforgettable. Now, I can already see some of you worrying about balancing friendships with the landslide of assignments and deadlines. Trust me, it's like juggling flaming torches while riding a unicycle on a tightrope, which is basically just cert at the fire station, so many of you have done it already. Don't worry, just remember that relationships are like plants. They need a little TLC, tender love and care, to thrive. So, water your friendships with laughter, sunlight, and the occasional pizza party. Trust me, pizza has mystical powers when it comes to bringing people together. Oh, and don't forget that college is also about making new friends. So don't be afraid to step outside your comfort zone and talk to people from different backgrounds, cultures, and even majors. Who knows? You might just find someone who knows the Dutch Bros menu better than you do. Probably not, though. In conclusion, my dear soon-to-be college freshmen, take the time to build meaningful relationships. They'll be the ones who celebrate your victories, console you during all-night study sessions, and remind you that life is not just about acing tests. So, as we venture forth into the wild jungle of college life, let's promise ourselves to cherish the friendships we make and to create memories that will make us laugh until we're old and wrinkly. Congratulations, class of 2023. And just remember, tables turn, bridges burn, you live and learn, but you will always have people who care about you. Let's make our mark on the world while holding hands with the ones who matter most. Thank you, and may the friendships be with you all.
Great job, Vals. Class of 23 and honored guests, I am proud to present and introduce you to the Superintendent of District 7 Schools, Mr. Tim Sweeney, to my right. He has prepared a special song for you. No, I'm just kidding. At this time, I would also like to thank our Grants Pass School District Board. Without the dedication and commitment of these school board members, Grants Pass School District would not have the tradition of excellence we currently enjoy. Round of applause for our board. As the last roll call is read by your class officer, the superintendent and I will confer upon you your diploma from Grants Pass High School. In recognition of satisfactory fulfillment of the prescribed requirements with all honors, rights, and privileges which pertain to this diploma. Chairman Wilkins, Superintendent Sweeney, I certify to you that each and every one of these students has met all the graduation requirements as established by the State of Oregon and the Grants Pass District 7 Board of Education. It is with pride that I present to you the graduating class of 2023. Students, before you come up, I want you to take a moment, look at the mountains in front of you, look at the trees and mountains behind you, look at your family and friends in the audience. Take in the moment. It is now my pleasure to introduce Brooke Alderson to the platform, as she will be reading roll call of the class of 2023. Brooke Alderson.
All right, our first graduate tonight, Bella Marshak. Marshak. Joshua Smith. Caden Erickson. Ellie Elise Berg. Pastrell. Addie Hole. Alexa Rose Medley. Reagan Bruner. Brianna Beltran. Nevaeh Gieske. Quinn Stratman. Liam Batrick. Kaylee Murphy. Haley Marshall Gibson. Chase Duval. Aiden Newton.
everybody.
Russell.
Brock Tyler Sandhill. Andrew Michael Wilser Monroe. Madison Peter. Nikolai Joel Ostrander. Patricia Elizabeth Aldrich. Brianna Alvarez Lopez. Michael Anthony Brown. Connor Nathaniel Upshaw. Lorraine Selvis. Alyssa Seal. Portia Dillon. Isaiah Williams. Brandon Martinez. Jonathan Hendrick. Ian Peter Tomara. Ella Lee Cook. Aiden Allen Deep. Roman Silvera. Heyon Gonzalez. Kane Robinson. Rahelio Sotero. William Spagnolo. Antonio Guerrero de la Puerta. Chloe Wood. Jaren Reno. Jackson Beaudry. Morgan Neal. Amalia Yana. Jasmine Marie Lynn Thompson. Brayden Paul Jeromsack. Luke Fetchworth. Harris. Mason Shears. Cameron Croson. Spencer Fall.
Thank you. to the teachers and support staff who helped all of us get here today, and to my family and friends who have been the best support system. I stand today here ecstatic for the next chapter of our lives and the success that lies in front of us. Yet so sad to be speaking to you all. Sad because I know this will be the last time our faces will all be sitting in the same place at once. My grandpa always said, don't take life advice from an 18-year-old. So I'm not going to sit here and make you all listen to life advice from an 18-year-old who has no idea what she's doing. However, I would love to give my class a thank you for all the memories. From the moment we stepped into our first classroom and waited to meet that friend that would be around, all the way through our education here in the Grants Pass School District. And now, sitting here graduating with many of those first friends today. We waited to receive that first report card in extra elementary recess, and most importantly, to the end of the year field day. We waited for the first day of middle school. That seems so scary, because why are those lockers that line the walls at North and South so big yet so small? Among many other things, we waited to put on this cap and gown and graduate high school. As little kids, something like this seems so far-fetched. Yet it's a reality. It's a reality that we deserve. Our senior class has been through it. Far too many rainy day recesses, a middle school clown scare, a pandemic, and amongst many other things. Yet somehow we came out of it all on the brighter side. I stand here today and notice that I spent much time waiting for these dreams to become a reality, that I didn't always take in the moments and cherish them as they were happening. I think we all took high school for granted just a little bit, which has made me reflect on how much high school has changed. Every little thing from these past 4 years has taught me lessons that I will use for the rest of my life. Everyone says that high school will be the best years of our lives, and for so long we've waited for that to be the truth. Now that it's finally time to walk away, I realized that waking up before 6 a.m. wasn't so bad. Waking up came with great relationships, report cards and grades that made you internally proud, iconic teachers, school dances, walking into classrooms and seeing a movie on the screen, and late night drives to clear your mind. Waking up before 6 a.m. was worth the joy that I was blessed with by all of you. The best advice I have for us is to not wait so much anymore. Soak in all the time while we still have it. Don't wait until all the good times are just good memories. Enjoy it all now. So may these last 4 years mean something to you as they have to me. And with that being said, the wait is finally over. Congratulations to class of 23. I will miss every minute.
Senior class president Brooke Alderson, graduates, asks you to take your tassel from the right side and pull it over to the left side. Congratulations!
Thank you. graduates and families will be leaving the north lot for pictures and picking up your actual diploma. Congratulations. Meet in the north parking lot. Walk to right through the quad. Thank you.
Let's go. We graduated. Class of 2022.
We had some audio issues, but...
Well, all of a sudden that mic kind of went quiet for when the valedictorians were talking.
Yeah.